So this is a Jeep Grand Cherokee Lorado. It's a 95. The Jeep threw a rod about 2 years ago, and it's been sitting around ever since. You can kind of tell that from the when it threw the rod, the oil came up through this and down in here into the air filter. Open this up, you can see there's a bunch of oil down inside of there. That's what's kind of the giveaway, that it threw a rod, needs a new engine. We're gonna do a engine swap on it. Started the front grille has three screws here, here, and there. You just unscrew those three things, grill comes up and off. Okay, so to take out the radiator, it comes up in parts. There's a bolt here, 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 here. So there's four along the top, and then there's two more underneath the bottom. So on the front grill, right above the license plate, here and here. And then the whole thing should just lift out. Alright, I finally got the radiator out. There's a few more hoses and connectors that needed to come off as well. There's this one right here, and then there's two more at the very bottom of the radiator. A big tube and a little tube. I will show you what those ones are. So that top one was here, and then the big tube and little tube. I took them off at the other end where it connects to the motor. That way I just have to take apart less things as I'm taking out the engine. So to get the whole thing apart, I did have to take apart the fan. That made it the easiest. It gave me a lot more room to work with. Once I had the fan out and the plastic shroud out, the whole thing gave me more room to get the radiator out, to move the cables around the big hoses. The thing that you always have to do is make sure to put all the bolts back where you got them, just to make sure that there's no chance of you losing them later on, because there's going to be a lot of leftover bolts and stuff like that if you do that, so better to stay organized. So we started taking apart the power steering, the pump for this, the reservoir. It's the same way to get the belt off of the engine. You undo, there's a few different slider bolts on the track down inside here. There's another one on the back there. You undo those slider bolts and loosen this one up as well. And this one, sorry, the sun is kind of in the way there. The whole system just kind of shifts down a little bit. You can see that it tracks up and down on those little runners. And then once it tracks down, the belt just kind of slides off of the whole thing. Remember where it goes. So when you're putting it back, all the components are turning in the right direction. That's an easy way to damage some stuff. Right here above the radiator, when all the pieces are intact, there's a little map, at least here on the Jeep Cherokee, that tells how the belt is routed. I have another engine for this vehicle right here, and you can tell the tracks that are right here. Let me see if we can. The tracks that are right here and right here, and that's where the reservoir can track in and out and release the belt. So that is how you take off the serpentine belt in a Jeep Cherokee. So as you can see, we got off the power steering fluid reservoir, started taking apart this thing for the AC. Pretty simple. This part up at the top, these are 13 millimeter bolts, there's four of them. I believe this was a 10 millimeter. These two tubes were connected to it. It is pressurized, so remember that when you take them off. There is also one little wire right here that you have to disconnect from the back. Pretty simple, you just have to lift up the little plug that goes in there and it snaps right out. It is pretty simple. Then the whole thing just lifts up and away from the motor. So to take off your alternator, there's a few bolts on the top here you have to take off. This one's a 15 millimeter. That one is also a 15 millimeter. On the back of this bigger, the longer one, there's a nut that you have to put the 15 millimeter socket on. And you can just ratchet it out. On the back of the alternator, there's a few different plugs. There's this guy right here, which has four connectors on it, if you can see it. It's got, I'll show you on the back of the alternator then. Right here, it's got, wow, the sun is really in the way there. All right, so right here, I believe these three are 10 millimeters. This one is a 7mm. You just disconnect all those. They're pretty simple. Nothing is really stuck on there too bad. And that is the whole deal, I believe. There is this red wire is the one that's connected to the in this black section right here. And that's how to take out the alternator. Alright, so now we're taking all the wiring and electrical stuff off the engine. There's a lot going on, so I'll just kind of explain what I remember. Just this one comes out, these two come out, these two just slide off, so this is all in the wiring. Everything inside this harness right here needs to come off. Basically, it's all these little clips on this connector. There was one, this guy was all the way down on the bottom. I don't know, basically it's just anything that looks like it's gonna come off, take it off so it doesn't rip off the engine when you're pulling it out. I'm trying to think of anything else. I don't know, basically what I've been doing, I've just been taking a look at this engine and taking a look at this one and just seeing, you know, what this one has and what the other one doesn't, and just going off of there. So this one's wired a little bit different than my other engine, so I'm just taking this out and replacing it with the one I have. These cables look shot, so I'm replacing them with the ones that I have. Those are already in there, it's just kind of like that. So, pretty straightforward. Just start taking things apart. Alright, so I'm on the underside of a Cherokee. This is the starter motor. Pretty simple to take off. There's a bolt here, that's a 14mm, I believe. Bolt behind right here. I already took off is a 15mm. Then we have this bolt right here, which is an 8, and this bolt right here, which is a 12mm. You take off these ones to get the electrical side of it off, and then these bolts are the mounting bolts, and then the whole thing, as you can see, just kind of already got the bolts off, just wiggles off and comes right out. Pretty simple. Alright, so here I am underneath the engine. This is the exhaust where it connects to the engine. Just make sure to take this off as well. I believe it's two 14mm bolts. The whole thing just kind of slides apart like that, and then it's disconnected and ready to remove from the engine. It makes it a whole lot easier is when way back there on the top of the bell housing, right above where the transmission connects to the engine, there's two bolts that are 14mm sitting at the top of that. But the way that the firewall is sitting over the transmission, it's super hard to get the bolts to turn. So what I found is these little wrenches right here with the ratcheting socket on them, where they can bend at that angle. That's the easiest way to get that bolt out. Now, I've heard a lot of people complaining that there's star bolts on the back of this engine that you need like an E12 socket for. But on this engine, this is a 95 Jeep Grand Cherokee, there weren't those star bolts. They were just the 14mm, just the regular ones that are all around the bell housing. So just be ready for that. But yeah, without this tool, I could not have gotten those off. So you've got to be ready for that. Made some progress. So basically what happened is down there on my flywheel, the engine had ceased. I wasn't able to turn the flywheel at all to unscrew the torque converter. Let me slide under here and show you what's going on. So right up in here, this big round thing is the torque converter. This is the flywheel. I'm on the flywheel. There's little bolts. Sorry, the camera's shaky. Those are the bolts that go into the flywheel. They were, since it seized, it wouldn't spin, so I could only get three of the four out. So I had to just pull the whole torque converter out with the flywheel. Most people on the internet said not to do it that way, but we'll see if it works. Also, to pull it straight out, the motor mount was getting in our way. So we just went ahead and just detached the motor mount to make it easier. I believe those was a 15mm bolt. This came right out. And then just as we went, we just made sure to disconnect all the extra wires and stuff. There's another one down here by the oil filter. The fuel line was also giving us some issues. What I did is I came in to the fuel line, and I undid this little screw. I'll show you on this other engine. On the fuel line, it's a little bit different. You undo this and release all the pressure inside, and I disconnected these, and then I disconnected the hose. I left it connected as well because it's pressurized and I didn't want to deal with attaching a whole new hose to it. Anyway, as far as connecting the engine to the hoist goes, I just used these big bolts right here, little chain, and then O'Reilly Autoparts was pretty cool. I just do a deposit with them, and then they give me a lift, $350, and then when I return the lift, they give me back my deposit, so it's kind of like renting for free. Anyway, other than that, we're just about to clear the whole thing, so that's about it. We got the engine most of the way up. I just want to show you some of the carnage right here. This is from when it threw the rod. Punctured a hole right in the engine there. You can see our, this isn't supposed to be coming out. If your engine, if this spins, if your flywheel spins, make sure you just take off the flywheel bolts. Make things a lot easier for you. Let's see if there's anything on this side. Oil pan's good. Holy crap. This is not supposed to be there. Look at that. Punked a hole right through that. Woo! Alright, let's get this thing out of here. Alright, so now that it's in the back of my truck, we can work on taking apart the torque converter. As you can see, down inside that crack is the bolts. See, the torque converter still isn't spinning. Just because the engine is seized up, you can see this hole right here. That would explain why it's not turning. Same here, hole on this side. Anyway, I can get my wrench down in there though, and you can see that I'm turning the bolts. So hopefully I can get those turned enough to get the whole torque converter off.